We have seen Kenya Airways out with numbers. They've released six-month results this morning. Revenue down 1.7%, operating profit down 8%. What is the market made of those numbers?
I had attended the Kenya Airways presentation, and they went into depth trying to explain exactly what has been happening over the past 6 months. My feeling is that Kenya Airways was well out of bad performance that we had seen recorded in the previous year, and we are expecting better results at the end of the year. In terms of the market response, my thinking is that the Kenyan market usually takes a bit of time before that information trickles in into the price of the shares in the market. So probably a reaction in the next 2 to 3 days, that is next week from around Tuesday on.
Let's look at their strategy. I mean, have they mentioned and placed any emphasis on their strategy moving forward? Because we know that regional travel has provided them with a firm footing, but this at a time where government has made a concerted effort at marketing Kenya as a tourism destination to out of the ordinary targets like Poland and Russia. I mean, in that context, has KQ started reviewing its strategy in the markets it's actually targeting?
Yeah, they have started doing that. If you have been noting, Kenya Airways has been increasing the number of routes that they operate in within Africa and also without. They're also very careful on and keen on code sharing. They indicated like that. They also have been very active in ensuring that there are higher frequencies to destinations that they already have within their reach. Going forward, my feeling is that they also are looking at hedging very carefully, not only in terms of forex, but also in terms of fuel. And they indicated that they are going to be reviewing those measures from time to time to ensure that they are sufficiently covered and they don't register higher losses where it is not necessary.
Well, they certainly have to be very careful with their hedging policies moving forward, considering that the last time they hedged that fuel price, it was at a fuel price that was sitting close to the highest that oil price has ever been. Dexter, let's move on to some other companies here. I mean, KCB in the banking arena out with numbers overnight as well. I mean, growth cutting into its profitability. We had operating costs up 21% against an operating income growth of 14%. I mean, what's your view on KCB within the banking arena right now?
I think KCB is quite a good brand in the Kenyan economy, alongside companies such as Barclays and Standard Bank. It's certainly one of the biggest banks in Kenya. Mm-hmm. I think they've been looking for growth by expanding to outlying sectors of the East African region, going into southern Sudan, a little bit into Uganda as well. And that strategy is probably going to pay off in the long term. Mm-hmm. However, in the interim, in the flagship branch, we have a situation whereby I think for the most part the economy hasn't really been doing so well, mm-hmm. and because of that, it has been feeding through into the results of the banks. To some extent, we saw the Central Bank of Kenya releasing an update in July to say that profitability had been hit quite hard, yeah. For some of the banks, and non-performing loans were up quite a bit. And as a result, we're not really expecting great things from Kenyan banks during the course of this year. However, looking forward to next year and so forth, they certainly are some recovery plays amongst some of the players, including KCB as well.
Justus, let's look at KCB there, because if we hone in on the numbers, I mean, it's net interest income that increased 36%, while non-interest income declined 9%. Is this a challenging position for the company to be in right now, in a context where we've had the Central Bank of Kenya really starting to exert pressure on some of the Kenyan banks to actually lower their interest rates in tandem with what the Central Bank itself has been doing?
My thinking is that Kenyan banks will be very careful in lowering their rates, given the fact that they are going through a fairly tough time. My feeling is that for KCB, interest income is going to be accounting for a large part of their total income. And if you look through the figures, they have increased their provisions for non-performing loans by around 100%, showing the fact that over time they are expecting more defaults coming in. However, given the fact that it has now started raining and the agricultural sector is likely to improve probably from the next year, probably the first quarter of next year, my feeling is that going forward, Kenya Commercial Bank is a fairly strong company, but in the short term, the challenges are there, and they have been fairly rapid in terms of their expansion. Probably 2 to 3 years from today, we could be talking about a different story where the company would have grown by a fairly good rate. At the end of this year, we are expecting some marginal decline in profits, probably below 10%.
Okay, and finally, KPLC also out with numbers late yesterday. I mean, we saw electricity sales up 52%. Total revenue went up 59% as well. Your view on that company and its prospects moving forward, Dexter?
I think power and energy is certainly one of the sectors in Africa we need to, investors need to bear in mind. And it's more so when you look at Kenya Power and Lightning. I think it's been a long while coming, and looking at the rise in profitability, 75% rise in its pre-tax profit. Mm-hmm. That has certainly been quite a surprising result. And I think going forward, as long as they continue to have review of some of their tariffs and their costs, they're definitely going to be a very good company to watch.